Hello everybody and welcome to another War Thunder upcoming content video. Just as a little update for you guys, while I may be a day or two late on some of these dev blogs, I'm not going to call it a major update, but the next update called Hot Tracks releases tomorrow on the 18th of December. It was supposed to release today, but it was delayed. And now they're releasing it tomorrow. So this ship and all the other stuff we've talked about recently in our upcoming content series will be available tomorrow. There's a post on the website for it, so just in case you haven't seen that yet. But for this particular video, we're going to take a look at the Pola, or Pola. I don't exactly know. It is a new upcoming premium cruiser for the Italian Naval Forces tech tree, since they don't yet have one of those. Every other nation does have one up to this point for their naval tech trees, but it has taken quite a while for everybody to get theirs. So Pola, or Pola, was the last ship of the Zara-class of Italian heavy cruisers to be constructed, intended to serve as the class flagship. Soon, this well-known veteran of the Italian Navy will join the ranks of the Italian Blue Water Fleet in War Thunder, docking in player ports with the release of Hot Tracks in the next major update. Briefly, it is the last ship of the Zara-class to be built, possessing only minor visual differences to its sister ships and offering premium in-game bonuses. So it's the Pola. It's a heavy cruiser of premium status for Italy of the 4th rank. Pros are that it has good balance of firepower, protection, and mobility, and premium bonuses. Cons are that it really dislikes airstrikes. There was a slightly more meme-y type thing here earlier when they first released it. Unfortunately, I didn't get to do my video when they did that, but they said really dislikes swordfishes, or easily spooked by swordfishes, which is, I believe, a reference to the actual ship from the Second World War. Which it did not get sunk by a swordfish, but I believe it took part in an air raid of swordfishes. So here's some history. In fact, they might even talk about it here. Might have to be, holy shit. What the hell? I've never seen so much. Here, let me, oops. Cons, spooked by swordfish. It looks like it's only, yeah, see, the comments are referencing the original post. So we got some screenshots here. So it's a very beautiful looking ship, but not much else to really say other than that. But at the very least, Italy receives their premium cruiser in some form at least, which means I think the US have the USS Helena, which is a light cruiser, right? The British have the Belfast. Don't remember if that's a light or heavy cruiser, though. The Japanese have the Mikuma. And the Germans have the Eugen, which is the only bundle premium. The Russians got their premium cruiser just recently in the last major update, and now the Italians get theirs. So everyone's up to date on their premium cruisers, at least. In War Thunder, the Pola will be soon joining the ranks of the Italian Blue Water Fleet with the release of the next major update coming to the game. Featuring virtually identical characteristics as her sister ship Zara, introduced in one of the previous updates, it will not only further expand the fleet size of the Italian naval tree, but also offer its prospective captains higher rewards thanks to her premium vessel status. As already mentioned, the ship inherits most of the core characteristics of her sister ship Zara, already familiar to some captains. As a result, Pola features the same balanced combination of firepower, mobility, and protection as Zara, making her just as versatile of a warship as Zara. Unlike Zara, however, Pola will be a premium ship, meaning aspiring commanders of this vessel will be able to obtain the vehicle by purchasing it in-game with Golden Eagles. Once obtained, captains will have the chance to earn more rewards for every action performed in combat. Furthermore, being also the first high-tier premium vessel available to Italian captains, Pola will allow players to unlock vessels faster across all ranks of the Italian Blue Water naval tree. Remember, it's not always about the fact that it gives premium bonuses. This is also a second ship to have in your lineup, not just a ship to have to grind your tech tree with. And here we've got some screenshots of the vessel. So it doesn't look like, from what I can tell, it doesn't look different to the standard one visually, like camouflage-wise. Usually, Gaijin's done a pretty good job by giving each of the premium ships for every tech tree thus far some unique camouflage, like all of the starter premiums that they added for destroyers. Each one of those has a unique camouflage based on their faction or nation. Oh! I stand corrected. there it is. There's the camouflage that this ship gets. I was going to say, because even the light cruisers for every nation has a unique camouflage that you don't get just on the standard ships. So there you go. That's that one. Looks pretty good. Very basic, very standard, I'd say, but it still looks like a very nice camouflage. And there's another shot of its ass with that camouflage on. So we'll soon dock and play reports with the release of the next major War Thunder update, giving seasoned captains the opportunity to add another iconic Italian warship to their in-game collection. So, yeah, it's exciting. It's, of course, going to be ridiculously expensive because it's going to be a heavy cruiser premium for Golden Eagle, so I would guess somewhere between the 7,000 to 8,000 Golden Eagle range. And as for other stuff that's been announced on the devlog thus far, well, you can see that a few of the items on here I have not covered yet, which is what we're covering next. But previous to this one, we have seen the Italian helicopter tree in the form of three new helicopters coming for them, at least three for right now. Then also for aviation, we have the United States A-7D Corsair II and the British Blackburn Buccaneer S-2. Other naval units include the HMS Invincible and SMS von der Tann battlecruisers for Great Britain and Germany, respectively. And for ground forces, they have shown off the Japanese STA-3 medium tank. And then there's also been some new visual effects for ground forces that are coming with the next major update as well. But we're going to start taking a look at some of the other new units coming to the next major update. Well, next minor major update in the next video.